classical music. Now, every culture that's developed to a certain point probably has a classical music. So when I'm talking about classical music, it could be from any of these cultures. What I kind of think of when I think of classical music is courts, the courtroom, you know, the courts of the monarchs and the monarchies, the cathedrals, and the concert halls, the three C's. So that's important to think of classical music that way, because it really is, it's a conservative type of music. It's not one that just developed from within the cultures themselves as a folk music. I mean, all popular music is a form of folk music, really. The classical music, you have your composers, and you have your written notation, and you have your traditions that have passed down through lots of time. And these classical cultures have influenced the popular cultures it's in some different degrees in different places. I have found two important classical music cultures that I have spent literally my life on. One of them, the Western, what I call West, what I'd say would be the Western classical culture. In other words, that of basically of Europe. Bach, Beethoven. And that of India, specifically North India. Now, I discovered North Indian classical music in 1965 in Boulder, Colorado, when a friend played a record for me of Ali Akbar Khan. I'd never heard anything like it in my life. And that converted me, and I became just devoted to learning North Indian classical music. Most all music that I've studied, well, the Western classical music. I wrote a symphonic piece and had it performed by the Long Beach Symphony Orchestra when I was in the Navy. I had no classical training at all. I learned by listening to records and going as a sailor and studying books from the library on theory and orchestration and counterpoint and those kind of subjects, and learning how to play, how to write this music on my guitar, no less, and got it performed. So, and I learned jazz guitar on my own. I mean, I really have learned keyboard, but North Indian classical music, you don't learn it on your own. And so, in 1965, I went to Los Angeles to study the music of North Indian. And I won't go into the distinction between North and South India here, but I'll just note that there is one, and it's more likely to describe. I ended up studying with a man, private study with a man named Harihar Rao, and he taught me sitar. 1966, and I left the West Coast, went to the East Coast in 1966 in September, traveled through the South, and ended up in New York City because I was going to study at Juilliard, which I did. I studied classical, Western classical music, but I continued to listen to the recordings, and I also, well, my sitar, I went into the recording studios and had lots of gigs playing sitar. Colin Walcott, who was with the group Oregon before he unfortunately died, I believe about in the mid-70s. He and I were on a lot of the commercials and recordings and stuff, because in that year, 66, 67, it was, Indian music was very popular, and because of the Beatles, I imagine it's the main reason. Now, my hero was Ali Akbar Khan, Ustad Ali Akbar Khan. I loved his music. That was really the main recording that I listened to was my record that I had, an LP record of him. He came to New York in 1967 and performed at Carnegie Hall, and I went up after the concert and met him and told him, bowed pretty much, and just said, "You're a master, and I wish I could study with you." And he said, "Talk to my assistant over here and get an appointment or whatever." And so I started studying with him. I was one of his first students in this country. There were five or six of us when we started out. When he in 1968 he left New York, went to the West Coast and started a school there, which is a wonderful school. It's still there. His whole legacy is there. It's wonderful how they preserve all his teachings. And I started learning tabla in New York, and I actually stopped playing the sitar. And when I was studying with Ustad Al-Akbar Khan, he's actually teaching me tabla. I wrote the first, the tabla or the drums. And I wrote the first tabla book in 1968. I had an offer, I won't explain how all that happened, it was through Harihar, who had written the sitar book. And I wrote this book, and it became, it was the first book on an instruction book for tabla. And it sold all over the world for 20, 30 years. I continue to practice almost every single day. I practice the tabla. It's something that's just part of me. It's so important to me. I could say so much more about all this right now, and how I studied the ragas with Ali Akbar Khan and with David Trisoff. I'll talk about that some more later, because it's just so much. But I want to say it's a part of my mission in life to make. I want to see this music taught in the universities of this country. I want to see it taught to students, not as something that you have to learn to play, because playing the tabla is very difficult, or to master the art of playing the melodic part of the music, the ragas. These are very difficult things to do, but to learn the appreciation, to learn the language of these musics. That's what I want to teach the composers and the musicians, because there's it's an advanced form of improvisation and rhythm, and melody and rhythm. There's a lot there that you won't find in the Western music, which is a development in harmony, and vice versa. So my classical section, World 4 of musical classical, is Western and Eastern classical music.